morning, everyone. It's like 10 a.m. and I want to sleep for longer, but this little devil is not letting me. He is a terror in the morning, I swear to God. Like, he just tries to get into everything. Like, right now he's gonna try to jump. I thought he was. Oh, don't do it. Don't do it. It's not gonna end well for you, buddy. He does that a lot. He, like, jumps from impossible places. He usually just wants to play, like, first thing in the morning. And I don't, because I stay up until, like, 3 a.m. So I'm back to feeding him wet food. We just got back from Walmart, and they had, like, a pack of all these little kitty toys. And they are so perfect for him. I just dumped them all over him, and now he's super excited. I got back, I was so nervous that he like got lost or something or he left my room, but he was just under my blanket. Hi! I think he was sleeping under there. Look at this! Oh, in his head. I just let Juniper in. Yes? They are so cute together. Although he likes to bully her. I'm gonna let them play for a little bit while I go eat. Aw, they're just so cute. Oh, big stretch. There you go, they're best friends. I wish he was nicer to her though. Enjoying his new toys. And Juniper is watching. So I thought I lost Patsu again, but it seems he has found a new favorite. Today we are taking Juniper and Sedona for a walk. Juniper is wearing Patsy's harness. It's too big for him. So we'll see. She doesn't usually like walking in a harness, so looks like she'll be okay, we hope. Did run earlier to them. Come on, let's go. Oh my god. I got him one of these super throwaways by Marshall, and it's expensive, let me tell you. $20 for this tube that I probably could have gotten at Home Depot for like much cheaper, but Home Depot's kind of far away, so I wanted to get him something that he could play with today, and seems like he's getting the hang of it.
When I introduce something new to Patsu, I always have to introduce Juniper to it as well. She's like, what the heck? She'd probably go in here if she could, but I don't think you'd fit. You, like, try to get him to go in. And you drag your finger. He has so many toys now, it's ridiculous. But I will never stop getting him toys.
Patsu's been having some tummy problems, so I've been giving him some probiotic, and it seems to be working. So I also mixed up his food, so it's a little bit of a more easier to eat consistency, since the dry food is a little hard for him to chew right now. Good news! It's been about a day feeding Patsu some probiotics to help his tummy problems, and it seems he is back to normal. And everything's good. So I also got two things in the mail today that I can show you guys. First thing, I got this Go Pet Club carrier. Sorry, the lighting is so terrible. It's pretty big for him, but it's really, really nice. I'll probably do a full review of it later, but like these sides have mesh and the front has mesh, so I'll be able to use this when I take him to the vet on Tuesday. I also got this cage for my car for road trips and trips to the vet. Again, I don't really like bringing animals in carriers, like small carriers. I feel like they get stressed out more so that way. So I figured, like, if I could try to recreate sort of like a more comfortable environment, like something that he would use at home, he wouldn't obviously stay in this at home, it's so small, but I just wanted something for the car so he wasn't like enclosed in a dark carrier. Just something about that is just not comforting for me, and probably is not for the animal as well. Hopefully our vet appointment will go a lot smoother. And I'm gonna try that Go Pet Club. It was really cheap. Both of these items were like $20-something. Okay, so I'm filming with a camera that I found, so this might not be the best. So today I'm gonna be showing you guys my new cage for Patsu. I did build this myself. First things first, these panels are called CNC. I got them from Bed Bath & Beyond. And it cost pretty much the same amount as like a normal cage would. The most expensive part of it was all the accessories on the inside, of course. But so far this cage, I was dumb and I didn't realize that he can slip through these bars. I've learned that pretty much anything the size of a quarter and bigger, a ferret can slip through. There's some pretty amazing videos out there of ferrets slipping through the tiniest, tiniest things. So that's part of the reason why he free roams my room now, because I really cannot just keep him in. So if you really want to build the CNC cage, definitely, and you plan on keeping them in here, definitely get like an extra mesh to cover it, or else they will be able to escape. It's fairly simple to set up. However, if like one of these pops off, like this one, it's like a mess and so frustrating to put everything back together again. And another thing is just accessibility to certain areas in this cage is really difficult, because it's not like regular cage where you just open the door and stick your hand in. It's kind of like, oh, this is the only open opening and then the top, so I really just have to like lift my arm up. It's very uncomfortable. Thankfully, he's not super messy on the upper levels of the cage, so it hasn't been too much of a problem, but again, keep that in mind. I guess I'll just go ahead and do the bottom levels first. So I got these mats from my local pet shop. It's just like a food mat. These are really nice. They have like an anti-slip on the bottom. They're just easy to clean like carpet.
I just wanted something to cover my actual carpet, and it works really nice. And we have a litter pan. And his food, he's really, really messy with his food, so that's why it's a huge mess. I took these ladders from his old cage. They're easy to climb for him, but they're kind of hard to descend. He's very lazy and very clumsy, so he just kind of uses it as like a slide and he slides down. He has a platform here, and then he can jump up to this one. He likes to sleep right here. He's not big on hammocks. He kind of just likes to sleep out in the open for whatever reason, but I have a hammock here. Usually I have his favorite hammock closer to the bottom level, so it's easy for him to access, but I wanted to sort of encourage him to explore more, so I put it on the top level. But he has a hammock right there, and he's got another ladder up here. I really like this level. It's two panels here, and he's got a tube and some toys. He also has another platform that he can jump to, or he can use another ladder. This one, nothing really too exciting here. He's got another water bottle that he does drink from, but I don't think he realizes that it's here yet. And then we have his favorite hammock. This is his banana hammock. He loves, loves, loves. The reason why it's so low is because he loves to just stick his body out of it. So he likes to be half in, half out. It's really strange, but yeah. I have a water dish here. And I have a woven sort of just little house. I think it's for bunnies. He likes to climb on top of it and kind of try to tear it to shreds. But yeah, it's pretty nice. I think it adds a nice little cozy feel to this cage. I'm definitely not finished with this and the interior. I want to get like a bunch of dangly toys to clip onto the ceiling, the ceilings of the cage. I just haven't found good ones for ferrets yet, but I definitely do like this cage so far. And he's got little Halloween lights. Have to be careful not to keep it too close to him, his range, or else he'll destroy them. If you're going to be getting a ferret, please, 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 get them a cage with multiple levels and enough room, especially if you plan on keeping them in there for most of the day and you're just taking them out for the 4 hours that they need to go out of their cage. But if you don't like have that time, or you don't have the space to let your ferret out, please, 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 well, one, don't get a ferret, and two, if you do have a ferret and you don't have that time or space, please make them a cage like this. Again, remember to cover it with mesh so they can't escape, and even so, keep an eye on them for a couple days before you leave them alone completely, just in case they find a way out. That's pretty much it. Hey, hi, Juniper. It's Patsu. Hi, buddy. Are you sleeping? Are you sleeping?